Look at all the buttons.
Start pushing the buttons.
Rest down the hallway.
You want a coloring book? Crayons. A hot dog.
So are we all running a little bit more? You can come a little bit more forward so everyone can get in.
So, Sabrina, can we get a comment?
We are at the Renewable Energy Station here in New Jersey. We're excited. We're going to learn about wind power. We're going to learn about solar. I'm here with Joe Dalton from Massachusetts.
Dude.
How does it get better than that?
It can't.
All right, guys.
Ben, can we get a comment? You never get on camera, dude.
Let's comment while we... Let's comment to each other while we...
Hey, you know, I think that's an excellent idea.
Right, yeah.
So this is just an incredible opportunity to see this type of facility, Ben. Thanks for helping us.
And I'm the sustainability coordinator with Corporate. Thank you all for coming. I'm really excited about this great start to the weekend.
Thank you. Well, good morning. My name is Paul Gallagher. I'm Vice President of General Counsel of the Atlanta County Utilities Authority. Michelle Bellinger is here. Greg Sayer is here. Greg is in the back. He's in our R&D. Michelle's in our, PR or something else. She schedules me for these all the time. In any event, I was the project manager on the wind farm project, so I do a lot of these tours. And I have most of the answers to questions people ask, but I'm not an engineer. I'm a lawyer. So if you ask me an engineering question, I'm going to make up an answer. Rely on the engineer.
A good lawyer.
In any event, welcome to the wastewater plant. Everybody thinks they're at the wind farm, but they're at the wastewater treatment plant. This is a facility which is, we have two roles, solid waste and wastewater management. This is where we take care of wastewater, 30 million gallons a day, high, high energy usage. And about 10 years ago, we realized that we had expenses, that we needed to control, and the government's tight, you gotta save money, and we decided how do we save some money in energy. And there had been some people from Atlantic Electric who thought that wind would work here. But Atlantic Electric in the late 90s turned into Connective, and we still don't know what Connective really was, but a lot of those people lost their jobs and moved on. Some of them actually moved on to the wind industry, and they actually put us in connection with some good partners who made this project happen. But the reason the wastewater plant is here is because when I was learning how to ski when I was 18 years old, I learned how to ski back here. And when I went to my draft as a goal, when I was getting drafted into Vietnam, they said everybody gets that disease when they go to Vietnam, so it did keep me out of work. But you couldn't swim, you couldn't climb, you couldn't eat the fish. Your back days then they were a mess. And that's because all these little towns had their own little wastewater treatment facilities. Nobody really moderated. They were encrypted to some degree, you know, some quality of cleanliness. They just come through the bays. And the bays were a mess. About 10 years after this plant centralized all that process in Atlanta County, got all 30 million gallons every day, cleaned it to 95% of drinking water. If I had the rest of it, it looked clean enough to drink. I've never seen anybody drink it, and I'm not going to do it. But if you look, these back bays are great. You know, there's good fishing back there, the clambers are back in there, and if your kid runs out of water ski out there, he won't be seeing a dermatologist when he's 60 years old like I do. Over here we have an osprey. Ospreys are seasonal visitors. They're very, you'll probably see someone will go out later. This osprey was killed by an automobile on Route 40 20 years ago. As a result, the guys here built a series of osprey nests on the island. This is a 55-acre island called Three Islands. They built some osprey nests. You can see one back there in that photograph next to this building. And this building is brown in that picture. Whenever you see a picture where that building is brown, that's before the windmills. We painted this building green, or some version of green. I'm not sure what color it is. It might be aqua, actually. But it's no longer brown, which was sort of the business we're really in. And when we became green when we built the windmills and the solar farm, we painted it this color, so you always can tell whether the picture's new or real. The best picture of the wind farm actually has a brown building in it because it's a fake picture. It's Photoshop. It's still my favorite picture of the wind farm, but we've replaced it with real pictures. And transparency doesn't matter. Anyway, this bird was killed by a cough. And they built these nests on site. When we got the permit to build the wind farm, We had to move those bird nests off the island. So the six nests that were on the island were replaced by about a dozen nests about a mile off from the marshes. All of them have been repopulated. The birds, the ostrich come back on my wife's birthday on March 26th every year. They leave right before Halloween. They're here all the time. Three have been killed, five turbans, six turbans were installed in 2005, three ostrich. The Audubon Society has been on site. They sued us when we got a capture permit. They were here for about 3 years doing radar studies, walking studies, and they found 30 dead birds in the period of 3 years. Our pre-construction study said that each turbine would kill two birds per year. Actually, in reality, it was killed less. What has been most interesting about it, however, is that the majority of the birds, only seven seagulls were killed out of those 30, and we have about 20,000 resident seagulls in the island. But there were 19 or 21 individual birds, songbirds, migratory birds, that were killed, all different species. What you don't see is flocks of birds flying in the windows. You see the stray bird on the fringe of the flock. Maybe it gets blown into it in a storm or it gets lost at night. But it's been single birds of different species that have been the mortality. So 30 birds isn't bad. The president of the ACUA always says his cat gets 30 in the clinic. I'm sorry for every bird loss, but there are costs to sharing this earth with other species.
I'd like to not be the ones that get shared.